Some games try to make you feel like Batman. And then there's Pizza Tower, that really feels like you're on cocaine. Wait, what's that say? Cooking, sorry.
What is that?
It's Pizza Tower, Chef.
What is that?
Yeah, I'm not very good at it, Chef.
We deserve better than this!
My thoughts exactly, Chef.
Unless you give me your best, go home!
First case in point, how many games have you played that have the honesty, the brass, to call you Dawful? Drop a bit of salmon on the floor, serve it up, good to go. There's no food temperature danger zone, there's no cross-contamination worries. And as far as success goes, just don't burn down the kitchen, don't serve it late, you're fine. With nothing to strive for and a very generous floor for failure, I start acting out. I listen to angry music and fling the plates everywhere. I'll put my hair down and salt the food until you say something. I'll make out with all the line cooks, the managers, and the customers. And it's all because Cooking Simulator never pat me on the back and never spanked me. Reason number two, the food industry is actually split up into four parts. One part business, one part health safety, one part actually cooking, and one part tequila. I've done it all and I'm sick and tired of the front end manager stuff. No, I don't want to make a menu. I don't want to balance the budget. I do not want to paint the food truck.
I really like this color.
Just let me in there, brother. I want to be the first line of attack against three buses full of grannies on an Easter Sunday. But the calm before the storm is also present. There's a term called mise en place, which means in its place with a French accent. This is the moment where you gather everything you're gonna need. The tomatoes, the onions, the lettuce are all washed and sliced. The buns are steamed. And that's what helps you go full throttle. Because you see, Pizza Tower is actually just a platformer. There is no rush, there's no timer. You wander around collecting ingredients and secrets. And as you take your sweet time, you can break obstacles and memorize the layout. All to make it easier for yourself for when you initiate pizza time. So by process of elimination, I've narrowed down the entire cookery genre to just two games, Pizza Tower and Cook Serve Delicious. Unfortunately, Cook Serve Delicious suffers from a fatal flaw. It's a typing game. It doesn't feel like I'm sautéing onions on the grill, it feels like I'm finger-pecking my way at the register. This game lacks the all-important tactile mastery of its predecessors, for you see, Cook Serve Delicious's real name is
俺の料理,
which is a fan-made remake of
俺の料理,
the real king of cooking games. This game had everything, the calm, the chaos, varying degrees of success and failure. But most importantly, it was the mastery of the analog sticks that immersed me and kept me playing the demo over and over again. You had to master the motion to peel the prawn, to pour the beer, and you could lose a finger if you didn't chop right. Unfortunately, only one game was ever made, and cooking games since then have struggled to fill the gap left by
俺の料理.
Until Pizza Tower. It's got it all, and the mastery of motion could be its own game. There's a wide range of abilities with the sloppiest elegance I've ever felt. The floors feel slick and sticky at the same time. And you hate every boss you've ever had. It doesn't quite capture the sexual tension that radiates from working at an Outback steakhouse. But few things in life do. Hey, hey,
I wanna be a cooking rock star.
If you made it this far, you get to help me name the series. For at The Escapist, we only have the best names. Adventure is Nigh, Cold Take, Design Delve, Extra Punctuation, In the Frame, Zero Punctuation, and my personal favorite, Thrimmer. Leave thoughts and prayers in the comments and share the video by any means necessary.